I'm Dr. Ray Padilla. What we're going to be making today with the TechFit fabrication method is a dual laminated mouthguard. We're going to be using two layers of 3mm material, first layer colored, second layer clear. Each layer is 3mm thick. This will not give you a 6mm mouthguard. There is approximately 40% shrinkage during fabrication. So this will give you about a 3.5 to 4mm thick mouthguard, exactly what the literature says you need as a minimal thickness for a professional mouthguard. First thing we do is we place the mouthguard material in the ring. These two holes you see right here must fit in these two posts. Okay, now we have to turn the machine on. So we'll turn the machine on from the back. You'll hear a little beep. That means the machine is on. Material is in the machine. We're going to place our mouth guard on the tray. Now, this model has already been pre-lubricated with orthodontic model soap for about 30 minutes. This will keep the mouth guard material or any other plastics material from sticking to the model and possibly breaking the teeth. It's extremely important to lubricate these models. If you don't have the orthodontic model soap, you can use Trim-Rite silicone spray by Dentsply. Again, once it's been lubricated, place your model on the tray. Now with the machine, you get a Essex plastic guide. This gives you all the different appliances it makes: retainers, splints, night guards, whitening trays, temporary anterior bridges, duplication material, mouth guards, bite planes, etc. What we're going to be making today is the athletic mouth guard, Drupasoft mouth guard. On the back, you have several barcodes. Depending on the thickness of the material, the color of the material, and whether or not it's the first or second layer. So we're using 3.0 color material. So this is what we want to scan, this barcode right here. Here's our scanning light. Now, to double check it, on the screen, it will say Drupasoft 3.0, which is exactly what this is, Drupasoft 3.0. Now I'm going to place the mouthguard material over the model, and I'm going to initiate the heating element over the material. Now the heating element, the material, and the model are all lined up directly. Now we're going to press OK. OK will start the heating process. When I press OK, you should see lights light up here. And you'll see a pink light haze right here. That tells you that the heating element is working. Pressed OK, that starts the process. The lights are on. So the heating element has just turned on. Now it's starting to count down. It started at a minute 50. Now it's down to a minute 36. So it's counting down. Once this counts down to the preformed heating time, you will hear a beep. When you hear the beep, you press this white button on the left and you pull back the heating element in a continuous, smooth method. Don't jerk it in a continuous method all the way until you can't pull any further. Press a white button and hold there until you hear a beep and there's pressurized. The cylinder will then be pressurized. Do not let go until you hear that beep. Now you heard the second beep. Now I can let go. Now the heating time now says zero because it's already heated. Now the cooling time now is 6 minutes. So we're down now to 548, 547, etc. So now that's going to go down to zero. Once this goes down to zero, we can open the cylinder and you'll have your pressure thermoformed first layer. There's my beep. So now I know it's cooled sufficiently. I'll press this white button. All the pressure will release. You may want to release these added pressure. Now that will rise by itself. Remove the ring. There is my first layer. And what you really want to make sure here is this is cooled down to room temperature. It's pretty cool now, but it wouldn't hurt to let it cool down for another 4 to 5 minutes. If you're in a hurry, place it in an ice bath for 30 seconds or so and just let it cool totally. You don't want to do anything to this while it's still warm because it will distort. Now that the first layer has cooled sufficiently to at least room temperature, now we're able to prepare it to accept the second layer. So we're going to be cutting the excess material away. Then after we cut it, I'm going to be going to a lab knife, a hot lab knife, and we're going to be trimming off the excess to the highest vestibular borders and to the linguals of the teeth. I usually go back to about the distal of the first molar. So we're going to cut through the distal of the first molar. And we're going to cut lingually around the teeth. And we're going to separate it. It will separate right off. Now we're going to keep it high here on the vestibular borders. The more you cover here, the better retention you have. So now we're going to cut to the highest level of vestibular border. And we're going to remove that excess. Now we're ready to add the logo and the name. Now, you can get preformed logos, such as the ones I have for my teams, or you can simply go to a computer, print a logo you want, find out which size you want to do it in, and then literally just cut it. I'm going to pick out the TechFit logo. Now we're going to use regular stick glue. And I'm going to place it right on the model. Now I'm going to place a name on here, the athlete's name. You can also do an expiration date. You can also do your own office logo, your own office phone number for marketing purposes. But for this demonstration, I'm simply going to put the athlete's name here. Now we're ready for our second layer. The logo is placed and glued. The name is placed. Don't do any trimming other than just cutting with a hot knife. You don't want to contaminate the first layer. Make sure your hands are free of any powder from gloves, any oils, any lotions that may prevent the second layer from laminating. Now that our first layer has cooled properly, we've trimmed it to the proper dimensions, and we've placed the logos on and the name, we're ready to start our second layer. Place the model on the tray. Here's our second layer of clear 3 millimeters. Place that on the ring. Line up our ring in the pegs. Set that material over the model. And now we're ready for our second scan. Now there's two ways of getting the second layer scanned. One, you can pre-program it in the machine, or you can just scan second layer. Either way works. I have already pre-programmed my machine to the second layer, which is 3 minutes of heating and 8 minutes of cooling. The first layer was much less than that. It was only 2 minutes of heating. So now we want this to heat an extra minute so it'll get softer, so it will laminate properly to the first layer. If you don't do this, you may not get proper lamination. So now we have it 3 minutes of heating time, 8 minutes of cooling time. Our model is over the tray. The material is over the model. The heating element now is over everything. Everything is lined up directly. Press OK. The lights are now on. The heating element has begun. We have a minute and 15 seconds left to go in the heating out of the 3 minutes. And if you notice, you're starting to get the drooping or the softening of the EVA material. It will be so hot that it'll actually touch the model. That's good. We want it that hot. We have 30 seconds to go. Remember, when it hits zero, you're going to hear a beep. When you hear that beep, one continuous slow method, pull back all the way with your heating element, press the white button, and the piston will drop. You'll hear a beep first when the clock hits zero. Once you hear the second beep, it's properly pressurized, you can let go. Now that's going to cool under pressure for 8 minutes. You do not want to remove it before that time. It will be too soft and your mouth guard will distort. We have approximately 45 seconds left in the cooling period. Once this hits zero, you will hear a beep. Then that allows us to press the white button on the left. That will release all the pressure and the piston will raise up, showing the finished mouth guard. Now it's cooled sufficiently. I can press the white button and the pressure will release. Now I remove the top ring, remove the finished appliance, and there's my TechFit red, white, and blue mouth guard. Now this has to cool sufficiently. It's still a little warm, just like the first layer. We want this to cool to room temperature. Once it cools to room temperature, then we can cut it, trim it, polish it, and we're ready for the patient. Now that our second layer has totally cooled to at least room temperature, we're ready now to complete the mouth guard with the trimming and polishing. So just as we did with the first layer, I'm cutting off the excess material. Just to give me a little bit of room when I use the hot knife. I'll turn the hot knife on. And then we'll cut the same borders that we cut for our first layer. So I'm going to trim. And you'll notice how quickly this works. The trimming process, start to finish with the second layer, should take well under 5 minutes. And then again, keeping the high vestibular border. The higher up you can trim this without causing a sore spot, the more retention you're going to have. Now, this last part is very key. We're going to trim this right to the teeth, and then I want a feather finish right here, so the athlete doesn't feel a bulk material of mouth guard lingually. So they don't all feel like the pump, like there's something back there. They want to be able to talk as clear as I'm talking now. I don't want this thickness here. You don't need the thickness lingually. You need the thickness labially. So we're going to trim this portion now. I'm going to use my red acrylic stone trimmers. And again, we're going to trim right to the teeth. Now we're going to air blow the internal just to get all those little pieces out. And I'm going to place it back on the model. And now we're going to trim that lingual area I was talking about earlier. Now when I run my finger back here, I don't feel a margin. It should feel flush with the model. Now I'm going to switch to my final polishing brush. And do my final polish. There's my mouth guard, properly trimmed, no margin, very, very comfortable. Now we're ready for the final polish. You can use a polishing liquid by Dentsply, the eucalyptus oil, or you can use a torch to polish. So very gently go over the margins and polish them. There's your final polish. You want to make sure you don't do this too much because you don't want to distort the mouth guard. You do this all the way around. Now we're ready for our final bite adjustment in the patient's mouth. So we'll get our torch and we'll gently heat the posterior. That's about all you need. You'll take the mouth guard off the model, place it directly in the patient's mouth, and have the patient bite until all the teeth are hitting evenly. It's important that the posterior teeth hit evenly. Then let it cool in the mouth, take it out. Your mouth guard is completely finished. The bite is adjusted. It's important to have the bite adjusted. Otherwise, in some patients, they're hitting only on the first molar area. And if they get hit in the jaw, the force won't be distributed equally. So it's very important that you bite adjust these in the mouth with every patient. Now, if your sport requires a strap, they can be placed on these. The strap is not necessary, but some sports require them. So you're going to heat the tip of your mouth guard, then heat the tip of your strap, then you're going to loot it together at a 45 degree angle and just let that cool. Once the strap is cooled, you're going to go back to your stone acrylic burr. You're going to trim the excess. Now you'll just air blow it, get all the particles off. Place your final polish again. Let this cool back to room temperature. Now you have your strap. Again, the straps are not necessary. However, if they are required, they can be placed on pressure thermoformed mouthguards.